am trying, Mike, to wrap my arm, and we're going to show it in a second. I'm still trying to wrap my arms around the fact that a United States senator from Wisconsin would talk about the existence of a secret society inside the FBI that was trying to launch a coup d'etat against the president of the United States. And when pressed about it, he said, we're looking into it. And then we find out it is one text that is a joke.
Right.
Is there a recall process for United States senators in Wisconsin? Because people not only around this country, but our enemies across the world heard a sitting United States senator say that he believed there was a secret society inside the Federal Bureau of Investigations that was planning a coup d'etat against the United States president.
That's big news.
It's going to be very easy for us this morning to laugh at the stupidity of it all.
No, we're not laughing.
There's nothing funny about people using conspiracy theories to slur the men and women of the FBI. It used to be liberals that attacked law enforcement officers.
Correct.
Certain liberals.
Yeah.
And we conservatives were proud to defend the CIA. We were proud to defend the FBI. We were proud to defend the people who we believe defend us. Now it is Republicans that are slandering and slurring the FBI at every turn.
So with Ron Johnson, it's clearly one of two things. Either he is of such limited intellect that he couldn't pick up upon reading those text messages, that it was a joke in the aftermath of the election. It was literally written right after the aftermath of the election. Or it's with malicious intent that he and others have combined in a cabal.
Yeah, who were the others?
Well,
you had Trey Gowdy. And who was he standing next to talking about the secret society?
But you also...
There's a secret society. We're going to look into it.
You have elements of people on television, on cable networks.
Oh, yes.
With a concerted effort to destroy the underpinnings, the hope, the trust that people have in the FBI.
So we're kind of backing into everything here, Willie, don't you think? Maybe along okay. with...
Willie has something
go to ahead, Willie.
Say,
though.
Willie, go ahead.
And then
no, you're talking about the Republican
me.
Congressman from Texas who was standing with Trey Gowdy, and he gave a speech about a conspiracy in the secret society that said, no, I don't know if it's true.
Mm.
Well, if you don't know it's true, don't throw that out there.
Nice.
This is again, putting Donald Trump ahead of the good of the country. And for what? Donald Trump doesn't care about them. They think they're getting into a foxhole with a guy who will turn on them as soon as he gets the chance.
And he's going to leave Washington, Mika. And when he leaves Washington, the music's going to stop. And there are going to be a lot of FBI agents. And there are going to be a lot of conservatives. And there are going to be a lot of Republican voters that are going to be staring at them and said, wait. You did what?
Why?
To defend Donald Trump? You claimed that a coup d'etat was being undertaken, and you based it on a joke in a text, and you let people believe for 24 hours that was... I know you have to get to Devin Nunes and what he's done. He's trying to release a memo that the Justice Department doesn't want released, that the FBI doesn't want released, that nobody wants released except... Wait for it. The Russians!
Yeah, great.
The Russians are actually with their Russian bots going hashtag release the memo while Donald Trump's own Justice Department is saying, if you release that memo, the contents of which you don't even know about, you will damage United States intel gathering. And yet, Devin Nunes... He's not listening to justice. He's not listening to law enforcement officers. He's following the Russians and their bots.